Hello students and welcome again to the digital classes by St. Paul's. And today we are going to start our second chapter, that is operating a computer system. Dear children, you have read in the previous chapter that nowadays computers are used in most places because they are fast, accurate and helpful. Okay? Now let's have a look at some wonderful features of a computer which makes it is so special and unique. Okay? So in this chapter we will learn about the study about the characteristics of a computer, understands the processing of data, study about various types of computers. Let's talk about it. Our first topic is speed, which makes a computer very unique and special. A computer runs at a very high speed, so it is called high speed data processing machine. It processes the data very quickly and save our times. Okay, save our time. There are so many unique features. Number two, accurate. If we feed the correct instruction into our computer, then it will never give us the wrong result. Keep in your mind, if we feed the correct instruction into our computer, so it will never give us the wrong result. So it is very accurate in its work. Now our third point is reliable. If any program is executed multiple times with the same input, a computer will always provide the same result. Hence, it is reliable. Okay? Now, storage. A computer has a large memory which can store a large amount of data in it, which can be retrieved quickly whenever needed. Okay? No. Now, next topic is diligence. A computer never gets tired of working. It can work for long hours efficiently. So, these are some special features which makes our computer very unique and special. But there are some limitations of a computer. Let's talk about that. Computers does not have any learning capability. It does not learn anything. Keep in your mind, computer have no any brain. It cannot learn anything because it have no any learning capability. Its knowledge and working is hidden in the programs installed in it. Okay? Number two, zero IQ. Computers cannot perform any action unless they are programmed to do it. Okay? So, the computer has the zero IQ. A computer cannot take care of itself. It is dependent on us to take decisions. Okay? So, they have no its own decisions. Okay? So, our next topic is input process output cycle. Let's talk about it. How the computer works. Okay? In IQ cycle, data and instructions are entered by the keyboard or any other input device. They are processed by the CPU, stored in the memory and finally displayed as a result of an output device. Let me show you. There is input device like keyboard or any other device, then process and then output. And this is called the input process output cycle. Okay? In the process system, The computer store the data. Okay. So in IPO cycle, data or instruction are entered by the input device, which we can say that the keyboard. They are processed by the CPU, stored in the memory, and finally displayed as a result on an output device at the monitor. Okay, it's called a monitor. On the monitor or the printer, it gives the result of the instructions. Okay, so the computer was on IPO cycle, input process output cycle. Now let's talk about the parts of the computer system. A computer is a combination of hardware system and software programs. A complete computer system consists of mainly four parts. Number one, hardware. In this section there are CPU, monitor, okay, some other devices also. Software is called a program. Number three one is data, the information. And number four is user, the people. Okay, so let's talk about the hardware, software, data and user shortly. Computer hardwares are the physical devices that can be seen and touched. For example, monitor, CPU, keyboard, scanner, printer, mouse, etc. These are called the hardware devices. Okay, which we can see and which we can touch. Software. Software is a set of instructions that make the computer perform tasks. In other words, we can see that software is a program that can be seen on the our monitor screen. For example, Paint, Notepad, MS Word, etc. These are called the software. Now, data. A data is a raw fact which is not useful for us unless processed. Data can be any alphabet, number, or special characters. Okay? Now, let's talk about the user. A user is one who uses the computer to perform some task. For example, teachers, bankers, doctors, and all the people who use computers for their work are called users, like you also. As you all are watching the video, now you are the user of that mobile or the computer. Let's talk about the types of computers. Different places use different types of computers. As their requirement, there are four